to study religion, because he said, realize that Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith, live how much you live, you are going to die at the end. And how much, whoever you love, you are going to leave. Either he is going to leave you or you are going to leave him. Either you are going to die or he is going to die. But the one who loves Allah Almighty, he is going to remain with Allah Almighty, because Allah Almighty never dies. And whatever you will do, Allah Almighty is going to give you according, reward you according to whatever you are doing. If you are working in dunya, you are going to be rewarded according to dunya. If you are doing good deeds according to akhirah, according to your eternal life, then Allah Almighty is going to reward you according to it. And then you will have paradises and you will be in the divine presence. Allah Almighty then put in his heart a kind of light, secrets, that the love of dunya to go out from his heart, and it was full, his heart was full with love for akhirah, love for awliya, love for Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, love for Allah Almighty. Then he makes zuhud, and he left everything, all his studying and everything, and all his degrees which he get it, and he turned his face to awliya and to ulama, scholars in his time, leaving all dunya after him and leaving people, family, all he left, and he started to ask for divinely knowledge, sharia knowledge, and about hadith, and especially about Sufism. He liked Sufism, and he was educated on the sheikh of all ulama in Istanbul at that time, who he was so well known in the Islamic world as a big alim, a big scholar in the learning of fiqh and hadith of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And his name was Jamaluddin Al-Suni. And after a while, several months, Mawlana was so popular and he was getting all kind of knowledge from this sheikh, the sharia legislation knowledge, and from the fuqh. He got the knowledge, then the sheikh was in need for him. And then Mawlana was so popular in Istanbul, and he was like an encyclopedia for the four mazhab, and especially for the mazhab of Sayyidina Abu Hanifa. And all the ulama at that time in Istanbul, they used to say that Shaykh Nazim, he is much more now, he is much more now deeper and higher than his teacher, Shaykh Jamaluddin Al-Suni. And then his teacher was in need for him if he has anything to make fatwa, advice, or to make fatwa to answer for anyone who has a question, deep question. He used to go to Mawlana Shaykh Nazim to ask him what we will say about this question or this problem or this advice. And while he was studying under the hands of this Shaykh Jamaluddin Al-Suni, one of the big awliya poles, Qutb, in his time, make a kind of attraction to him and make him to come to him in Istanbul. And he was a Naqshbandi Shaykh, big awliya he was. And he told him, it's not enough for you the sharia knowledge, I must teach you Sufism, about awliya, about the divine knowledge and secrets and wisdoms. Because he used to be the Qutb al-Mutasarrif, the pole whom Allah Almighty dressed him by the will of Allah Almighty. He was dressed this awliya. And his name was Al-Arif Billah, the knower of Allah Almighty, Shaykh Sulaiman Arzurum. And he used to be known as the Shaykh of all Shaykhs in the Turkish territories. Shaykh al-Mashaykh. Shaykh of all Shaykh. And he used to be one of the big awliya whom they are, his name is listed on between the name of 313. There is a group of awliya, 313, their number. They are Rijalullah, the men of Allah Almighty, whom Allah Almighty dressed them to be as a khalif for him in the earth. And they come, everyone in his period of time, according from Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Yawm al-Qiyamah. Only they are 313, not exceeding, not decreasing. They will be like this. and he was one of them. And they are representing, why they are 313? Because they represent 313 prophet messenger. Because from the 124,000 prophets which Allah Almighty sent, there is only in between them 313 messenger, prophet and messenger of Allah Almighty. Not all of them, they are messengers. No, all of them prophets. But as a prophet messenger, they are only 330. And for this group of awliya, everyone has a secret from one of these prophet messenger, 313 of Allah Almighty. And this awliya, Sulaiman al-Zurumi, he was so taking care of him, educating him, making him to practice and to walk in the line of awliya, divinely knowledge, divinely secrets, until Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, at that time, he was Imam in Sufism. And he is yet only 23 or 23 years old. And the best moments for him at that time to be praying in between the hands of Allah Almighty. Whenever anyone wants to find him, he will find him praying. Allah. Never sitting. Allah. Thousands of raka'at he used to do, Allah, day and night. Then he told them, this Shaykh al-Zurumi, Sulaiman al-Zurumi, he told them, my son, I educated you and I behaved you very well, that I can't give you anything more. I am stopped here, but you are very hard, because your himma, your powers, your energy is much more higher than what I was expecting or what I have. So I ask Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spiritually, what I will do with this, my son, Shaykh Nazim, what I will do with him, so energy, so high, that I am not able to continue with him. He's higher than me now coming. He's now Imam in Sukhinat. He told him, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spiritually, his spiritual amana, trust, his spiritual trust, which Allah Almighty gave him, and his promise in day of promises, not with you. For this, you are not able to continue with him. His spiritual trust, amana, and his, in the day of promises, he has the promise with the sealed of awliya, with sultan of awliya, the ghaus, the highest maqam which all awliya need him of this time. And he is living in Damascus, Sham. And his name is Sheikh Abdullah al-Daghestani. By my order, I send him to live in Damascus. He immigrated from Daghestan to Turkey, from Turkey. After his Sheikh passed away, I ordered him to settle in Damascus. And there, send him, he must continue under the hand of his Sheikh. He can control him and give him whatever you cannot give him.